Film simulation emulation. I would arguably say that has been one of the biggest trends over the last year or so that's kind of taken over the photo and video world. With new cameras such as the Fuji X100V taking the top of the trends, and the last time we talked about this, we actually reviewed the Fuji X100V to get a first inside look what all the hype was about this new topic, basically. And now we're talking about it again, but the other side of it. The first side, the one with the cameras, the one with the Fujis and everything like that, I categorize those more on the physical side of things. Physical side of being able to replicate film with cameras such as the Fujis that have built-in film profiles that you can utilize, but other forms such as lens filters, such as the black chromis filter to soften your image, different types of lenses. Now the other side is post-production. In post-production, there's different ways such as LUTs, presets, plugins that you're able to color grade and manipulate any type of footage to get the look you desire without even having none of the physical tools. And the last option, plugin, is the thing we're talking about in this video. A company called Dehancer is said to be an OFX plugin suite for film-like color grading in software such as DaVinci Resolve, Premiere Pro, After Effects, and also on the photo side of Lightroom and Photoshop. All of my clips that you see right here, I have edited with this plugin, Dehancer, built into Premiere Pro. Let's take a deep dive. I'm gonna give you guys a thorough review on this company, this product, and this plugin. And by the end of it, I'll give you guys my thoughts and to see if it's worth it for myself to use and for you guys to pick up as well. So for this review, I'm going to be reviewing the plugin for Premiere Pro. I am an avid Premiere Pro user. Okay, I'm thinking about transitioning into DaVinci Resolve for color grading purposes, but I will rock with Premiere Pro until I can't no more. And the majority of the videos that you might have already seen with this plugin is for DaVinci Resolve, but I'm not there yet. I've just started exploring DaVinci Resolve, so I'm going to be reviewing this product for Premiere Pro. All right, so a basic overview on how this plugin works. So you choose the software you want it for. You download it to your computer like any other software application that you do. Want to make sure if you have Premiere Pro open that you close it and reopen it again. Once you reopen Premiere Pro to your effects panel, search up Dehancer and it's going to be right there. You then drag and drop that Dehancer effect on an adjustment layer in your effects controls. That is where this plugin will now live. At the bottom, that bottom panel is where you log into your account and you want to make sure that you activate it for this software for it to work. Just by looking at it, you have 16 different sub panels that create this full plugin. Top down, to me, it just seems like a full color grading process. First panel is called input. That's where your basic color corrections are done, such as turning your footage to Rec 709 or even picking the specific camera and color profile you shot it on. It covers cameras from Sony Reds to Blackmagic to even your Apple iPhone. As you go down, that's when you get into the film simulation panels. It offers you 63 different film profiles that you have access to that range from any type of film that you could get on the market, from Kodak, Fujifilm, to anything you can think of. The most famous effects also, which is halation and bloom. Halation, what it basically is this. You see a spark, maybe an edging red line, like a glowing red or yellow light on me and on my background. And another panel such as controlling film grain and things like that. Off rip, what's so cool already, it's not just one simple kind of panel. Each individual one has an in-depth kind of advanced capabilities of customization. You're able to control the film in shadows separately, in highlights separately, or the amount you want in the mid-tones separately. And it's the same with the halation and bloom and things like that. So yeah, so look, it's looking really, really cool already. I'm going through the full plugin and kind of messing around with it, seeing its capabilities, seeing what it can do, and how far I could take it. Only use this plugin before I might have to bring in another adjustment layer or something else, right? This is where I ended up with this clip before, with my regular editing routine to where I ended it up with Tehancer. That one is done with the system that I have already been doing for so long, which consists of having four different adjustment layers where I kind of do these steps manually. The first one to be Rec 709, the second one to be color correction, then the third one to be my LUTs that I want to work with, the certain look that I'm going for, and then maybe the fourth one is my interpretation of trying to get that film look halation or bloom and things like that. Listen, before you roast me, everyone's editing systems is different. Mine's messy. Mine might look crazy to you, but it works for me. Comparing that to just one adjustment layer, this is the end where I came up with this clip using the Tehancer. And just by viewing them together, it impressed me so much already. It was time to take on more clips to try to push it, try to come up with different looks and play around with a lot more film profiles that it offers and seeing where I was able to take them. That's what you're seeing right here and right now. All of these clips, I use only the Tehancer plugin to color grade from where they were in the beginning to the end. Try to push the film further as much as I can. Try to push the grain further, the halation, the bloom. And I ended up with these end results in all of these clips from before and after. Tell me, what do you think by just seeing the before and after to all of these clips? How good do you feel like it replicates that film look? So now let's talk about the pros and the cons to this plugin. Pro number one, I think it's very easy to download, very easy to use. I have not had any problems with it slowing down my Premiere, my projects, or crashing in general. I do my color grading at the end already, because like I said before, I'm usually working with 4 to 5 adjustment layers, and that kills my computer crazy. Yeah, it's good. It hasn't given me problems whatsoever. And if it does, if I wait until my project, until the end to do the color corrections, it would still be kind of the same kind of circumstance I've already been dealing with. Another thing I really like about it, this plugin gives you 16 panels, and each panel is very customizable and very advanced. Just like you would use like a very advanced color grading system, if it's a physical color grading board or a better kind of color grading software such as DaVinci Resolve, being able to control more than just the intensity of a normal kind of film look LUT is a big bonus to have. Also, a big thing that I love, I know most of the people love the having halation, having bloom effects and things like that. Those two type of effects that might not be in Premiere right now, those are already in like softwares like DaVinci Resolve, and it's only a matter of time before they get added to Premiere. But you're able to replicate that in other ways in Premiere. But my biggest thumbs up panel for this plugin is the film compression sub panel. I think that's what takes it from it looking gimmicky to looking really good. The film compression compresses kind of like the highlights, the way film looks, but even the whole image in general. That's a huge W in my book, and I haven't found anything so far like an effect like that from looking gimmicky and amateuring to that professional level. And also little pluses, kind of the 63 different type of film profiles that they offer you that you are able to have access to. That's a great number to have, because when you buy packs from your favorite kind of videographers and things like that, those packs maybe are like 30, 40, 50 bucks that they only offer like 10 at a time max. And for you to have 63, you might never even need any more LUT packs whatsoever. So that's a big plus too. Now let's go to the things that I would change and as a con. The biggest thing that I have like a con that I would change about this, I think the overall pricing for Premiere Pro and After Effects, it costs $400. I think it's the same for DaVinci and things like that. And that is pretty steep considering that the DaVinci Resolve, like the whole program, $100 cheaper. My thing to kind of combat that, my own con, right? I could argue that even though it is $400, if you even go back to kind of looking how much it would cost to even get those tools physically, like a camera that shoots film simulation profiles, that has those color profiles, or specific lenses that will create the the image you're looking for, even lens filters that you can soften your highlights, create bloom and things like that. All of those cost a lot of money. Even two lens filters can run you $250, $300. And then on the other side of it, on editing software, you've probably already bought so many different LUTs, so many different like effects and things like that, that maybe got you around another $200, $300. So already you might be $500 deep. You're not satisfied with what you bought. And in the long run, I feel like a product like this is worth it. It also isn't a one-stop shop. How I would use it, do my basic corrections, things like that, and then bring this in at the end. Because to me, it is like a LUT on steroids. That's basically how I would describe it. Most customizable LUT that you can ask for. Before I give my final sign off on if I feel like is a good tool or not to add to your arsenal. If you haven't even gotten to like that point of picking a specific software like Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve, something that's really, really cool about this company, they also have an app. And it's not only just an app where it's like they have little tiny effects that you can put. All these different panels that they offer in Premiere, they offer in this app for photo and video as well. It's both compatible with iPhone and iPad. If your editing bay consists of an iPad right now, it's compatible with that. These are some before and afters of what I did to some of my photos. And the overall, the color and the tools you get in the app are similar to the ones you get on the desktop software plugins as well. There's years of scientific research behind their technology. If you don't know yet, if you even want to buy this plugin, I would say highly recommend downloading the app, getting your first looks at it before you make a decision on if you even want to buy this for your specific software. Cool. My final thoughts with this plugin. After reviewing it, after color grading all of my clips, have to give it the stamp, my stamp of approval. I know moving forward that I'm going to be using this plugin and I will be integrating it in my overall routine when it comes to color grading. That's me just being real and I'm just telling you that I'm going to be using it. For me, I really like this style, this film-like style, this film look, this soft look. And for you, it might not always be your thing. It covers that whole category so well. I don't think you would need anything else to recreate, to hit that film category. And for it to be in your locker to pull out whenever you need it, it's kind of like that perfect kind of package for it. I want to give a huge shout out to the Dehancer Company for tuning into our channel, tuning into our community, being the first kind of brand to hop on board, to give us a product to review, to maybe recommend to my community, to you guys. So yeah, that's it. That's the full video. I will see you guys next time on the next video. Stay safe. Always do what you love. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.